I'll be delivering this lecture. So, with your permission, shall I share, start my presentation, sir?
Yes, yes, sir. Go ahead.
Once again, I welcome all of you for this virtual training program on management of canopy architecture in Mango. Slides are visible. Are the slides are visible? I'm sharing the screen. Sorry. Not there. Oh. So my topic is concepts and practices in mango canopy management. I think back 6 years back in 2015, we conducted one training program, that is physical training program in canopy management by this institute. I think agriculture department officials and farmers have participated in that program. It was actually conducted physical mode. And this, as Neville sir has mentioned, after this pandemic, we'll be conducting a physical original training program for our farmer friends and agriculture department officers. But now we are mostly emphasizing on the theoretical part that we can deliver through a PowerPoint presentation. Theoretical part, concepts, and major practices. I'm trying to give importance to this portion, theoretical portion. Lights are not moving. So majorly I'm going to cover the what is a canopy and what is the importance of canopy and what is the principles of canopy management, major techniques, training and pruning, major methods and the equipments used for this canopy management practices. So mainly, what are the reasons for the low productivity of mango in India and in Goa also? So while pointing out the major reasons, first one is our orchards are very old, 40, 50 years of orchards we are maintaining now. And those orchards have very big trees with a huge canopy. And all the branches of these trees are interlinked and they're crisscross. So that proper light light penetration is not possible in this orchard. And that reduces the productivity of the orchard. So that is one of the major reasons of low productivity of our orchards, huge trees and with crisscross branches. Second one, the poor light infiltration due to the close spacing. Usually mango is planted in like a very wide spacing, 8 by 8 or 10 by 10, but sometimes very close spacing, like 6 by 6 or 5 by 6 close spacing also now people are following. But in that case, in such close spacing, if you're following, you need to go for proper canopy management. Otherwise, poor light infiltration will happen and that will reduce the productivity. Another thing, irregular bearing. Bearing in mango is having a peculiarity of biennial bearing. Actually, 1 year on and off year will be there. 1 year, good production will be there. The next year, automatically the tree will reduce its production to balance the growth. So that is irregular bearing. That is a natural phenomenon in mango. That can be regularized by giving a proper canopy management or canopy pruning treatment. So irregular bearing, that reduces the yield. Entire yield will be reduced with that. Unfruitfulness. This is the complaint given or blame raised by many of the farmers that their mango trees are looking healthy and having a good growth, but it is not bearing. Unfruitfulness. There are several reasons for this. And one of the reasons is the imbalance in the reproductive and vegetative growth. And this imbalance can be managed by the canopy management. So, if you are allowing the tree to grow continuously, the vegetative growth will increase and the plant will start produce new leaves, and the flower production will be reduced. So that imbalance can be managed by proper canopy management. Another thing is low quality fruits. If you are allowing a densely packed canopy in a mango tree, the quality of the fruits that is produced will be less. Like more disease and pest prone situation will be there, and the quality, especially the TSS and acidity, and the flavor of the mango may change due to this microclimate that is developed in the canopy of the tree. So in an orchard, if you are considering low quality fruits, things that is not a recommended thing. So we need to do the proper canopy management for the quality fruit production. Pest and disease in a closely spaced orchard, there is a chance of more microclimate buildup, and this will be a congenial condition for the pest and disease infestation. So that is another reason, like leaf fiber problem, like stem borer problem, shoot borer problem. All these problems may arise in a densely packed orchard, and the management operations will be very difficult in a packed or closely spaced orchard. So ultimately, the final effect of all this thing is a poor, unproductive or low productive orchard. So finally, farmers will get minimum income from the mango production. So that is a problem really existing. And now, what are the strategies that can be adopted to improve the mango production, the strategies? So I tried to put some strategies in the long, short term, medium term and long term approaches can be adopted. Sir, anybody is asking any question? I couldn't clearly hear you. At the end of the presentation, you can ask the question. There will be a feedback session and interactive session will be there. Please ask your questions during the interactive session. So coming to the short-term strategies, all the management practices that can be adopted in the orchard that is coming in short-term strategies, immediately the effect will be reflected. And the first and foremost thing is canopy management. It includes different procedures that will be, we are going to discuss the canopy management practices in detail in later coming on slides. Then another one is integrated nutrient management. So proper, actually in a rainfall cultivation, now we are not properly giving fertilizer application or irrigation, water management, nothing we are following, just planting, and we are expecting the tree to produce good quality fruits in more number. So that is that is not a correct way. If you want to maintain a commercially viable orchard, proper nutrient management practices and proper irrigation and water management practices need to be adopted. So if you start doing that, that will be a short-term strategy to improve the mango production. Another thing is integrated pest and disease management. Mango is having, right from the nursery, we need to go for the integrated pest and disease management strategies that include the organic thing and inorganic application in a combined way. Especially in mango, fruit fly is a major problem. Stem borer problem is there. So integrated management practices need to be followed. Another one important thing is phytosanitation. Sanitation of the orchard. Orchard should be maintained very neatly to avoid the infestation of the space, so that the production, we can save the production. Whatever production is happening, we can save it. And the final strategy is post-harvest loss management. See, India is the second largest country in production of fruits and vegetables, but we are not utilizing the production proper way. So there is up to 30 to 40% post-harvest loss is there. So we need to manage the post-harvest loss also. That will also improve the overall production of mango. So these are the short-term strategies. Coming to the medium-term strategies, rejuvenation of the senile orchards. As I mentioned earlier, our orchards are very old. Our forefathers, our ancestors have planted very long back. And that time, the major varieties they have planted, or local varieties, that will be a seedling population. And seedling population will be having a variability. There won't be any uniformity. And they might have not done any kind of canopy management. So the trees will be tall with different shape. It will be taking a lot of huge branches. And recently what happened in the cyclone, all the huge trees were uprooted in the Tote. You know that cyclone happened because the shape is not maintained. trees are having their own shape and big branches there. All the branches are like coming to one set means finally the tree will be damaged. It will be uprooted in the heavy rainfall or the cyclone when it happens. So the rejuvenation of the Senil orchard is required. With commercially existing, commercially viable, good varieties, we can go for top working. After rejuvenating, the top working we can do with improved varieties. So all these techniques we will be discussing in detail later. Long-term strategies. Coming to the long-term strategies, we need to adopt advanced production technologies. This is the time. Actually, in fact, this is the right time to adopt the advanced production strategies in mango, so that it will be continued for at least after next 5 or 6 years, we can expect a good yield. So right from the starting, selection of varieties. From that time onwards, we need to take the advanced production technologies, climate resilient varieties, regular bearing varieties. And now climate is not under our control. So we need to select the varieties that are adaptable to the climate change, that are adaptable to the drought, that are adaptable to the salinity. So depending on our situation, we need to select the varieties which are climate resilient. Rootstock. While selecting the rootstock, we have never given importance to the mango rootstock. So whatever seeds we are getting, we are raising the seedlings and going for seedling grafting on that. That is not correct way. We need to select the right rootstock so that the plant strength will be good. It's the canopy management. So one of the aspects is the selection of dwarf rootstock or the limited rootstock. So the rootstock, if it is a vigorous and limited rootstock, the tree won't be that huge. We can manage it. So the selection of rootstock is another important thing. And mass multiplication of the existing varieties, quality planting material production, that is another important. Finally, we need to go for ultra high density or high density planting with proper all these management practices. If you're going for a high density planting or ultra high density planting, we need to follow all the management practices in the short term strategy mentioned. One of the important thing is canopy management. Then proper irrigation, nutrient management, either by fertigation or drip irrigation, integrated pest management, and post-harvest loss management. Now, coming to our main topic, canopy and canopy architecture. So I want to briefly tell what are these terms. What is the meaning of these terms? Canopy means a lushy green part, whatever we are seeing in a tree, any tree, that is the canopy. It includes the shoot, leaves, flowers and fruit, the overall portion of the tree, greeny portion. So that is the canopy. So if you imagine a tree, first canopy only comes, if there will be umbrella shaped canopy will be there, columnar canopy will be there. So that is the tree behavior. And the canopy architecture is the structure or the way how this shoot, leaf, flowers and fruits are arranged in the canopy. And for different trees, the canopy architecture will be different. And for commercial production of mango, we can regulate the canopy according to our wish, our convenience, we can regulate. Why this canopy management is secured is, it manipulates the canopy's height and size for optimizing the production. For our convenience, we can manage the size for easy harvest, easy operation, easy management operations such as spraying and all, we can regulate. Reduce and regulate the shape and size. And this will help proper light infiltration inside the canopy. All the leaf will get proper light and the plant can completely utilize the sunlight that is receiving. The leaves are the sink portion. Leaves are receiving the sunlight and finally it will be converted as a fruit. Like it will convert the energy, photosynthesis into the fruits. That's the sink. So, source to sink relation management, that is the canopy management, that is scientific thing that is happening in canopy management. So as a definition, if you say that is a, it's a, like a combination of pruning and training branches by scientific way to increase fruit production and maintain the tree size manageable for a longer duration, that is the canopy management. It includes a series of operations starting from the planting. You will be training the trees to get a proper structure, shape, and finally, pruning the tree to maximize the production and quality of production from a unit area. So these are the concepts or canopy management definition. Now coming to the principles. So maximum light utilization, that is the principle. All the leaves in the tree, available in the tree, should get proper sunlight so that this sunlight can be effectively utilized for the photosynthesis and finally good production, quality production can be ensured. Then avoidance of buildup of microclimate. As I said, the microclimate buildup inside the canopy will be a problem since it will be a congenial for pest and disease for attacking. So we need to avoid that. That is another one. Convenience in carrying cultural operations, especially spraying of growth hormones or spraying of pesticides. So easy operation is possible in a low canopy. Because if it is dense, all the leaves may not get proper spray solution. So we have to manage the canopy for getting the proper effectiveness. And maximum productivity, quality production, and finally the economy in obtaining free canopy. So these are the principles that we need to follow during the canopy management. Methods of canopy management. Actually, there are two major steps or major techniques in canopy management. First one is training. Training is a process that is starting from the beginning of the orchard. Beginning of the tree production. So the initial years itself, we will be training or cutting the tree to get the proper shape. So after getting a full growth, the tree will be looking in a particular shape. That shape we are maintaining using the training technique. So it manages the growth pattern in the initial years. You can see here central leader system, modified leader system, open way system. So these are the different training models. We need to follow for fruit bearing trees so that everywhere you will get proper light infiltration. So we will be seeing one by one what are the central leader model or modified leader or open waste model. Central leader system. Central leader system, if you see, this will be the columnar shape will be there for the tree. This columnar shape, how we can maintain, we will be seeing. It will allow the tree to grow uninterrupted for many years. At least for 2 to 3 years, we'll allow the tree to grow without any interruption. And the secondary growth from the central axis on all directions will be allowed so that the tree will get a columnar shape. The tree trunk become very strong in this because from base onwards, in all four directions, you are getting secondary branches. And from secondary, you will get tertiary branches. So the base will be very strong. This is a very suitable system for a heavily bearing tree like a mango. This kind of training method is very much essential or very much useful. So this system is suitable for mango. Another system is open center system. This system is mostly followed in temperate trees actually. In this you can see the center is open. That is, as the name indicates, the center is open, open center. So immediately after planting, we will be heading back the center portion. Center portion we will cut back. So there won't be a terminal portion over there. Then we will be allowing the branches from 4 or 5 branches from all the direction so that it will be like an open vase. Okay. So that is the open center. Then the top growing axis is cut again. Whenever it is growing, the top portion is always cut again so that the tree canopy will be always open. Only the selected branches are made to produce secondary. So then secondary branches also will be doing pruning so that there won't be any congestion in the secondaries. Not only the primary main trunk we are cutting, the secondaries also we are pruning. So that is another thing. This is followed in temperate fruit crops. This one is the third training method, that is modified leader system. It's a combination of the central leader system and the open center system. So the initial years, you can see, first it is like a central leader. It will be growing uninterrupted for a few years. Then we will be cutting and then it will become as an open center. Central axis is allowed to grow unhindered or uninterrupted for 4 to 5 years so that it will reach up to a 3 to 4 meter height. Then it will be headed back to open the canopy. So that is the way modified central leader system is there. There won't be any breakage of limbs. That is important thing because already the plant is having a very good height and then proper opening of canopy will be there. So this system is also suitable for mango and crops like guava, it is very suitable. So this is the three major techniques of training. Training has to be initiated immediately after the orchard landing. If you're going for open center, immediately you need to head back. In mango orchard, up to 2 to 3 years, we can allow the tree to grow continuously, uninterrupted. Then we can go for either central leader system or modified central leader system we can go. The second most important method is pruning. Pruning is the judicious removal of the parts to regulate growth of a tree and enhance production and quality of fruits. Pruning includes cutting, simply cutting of branches. All the unproductive, diseased, unwanted branches only we are cutting. So this operation regularly we will be doing. So coming to the major objectives, the removal of the apical dominance to encourage branching. More branches will be encouraged by pruning. So that is the major thing, major objective. It will be removing the unproductive and overcrowded branches. Only the branches means not in the main trunk. Pruning operation will be on the branches or the secondary or tertiary branches only will be pruning. But the training operation will be doing in the main trunk. So that is the difference that you need to understand. What is the training and what is the pruning? The main trunk, if you are cutting, that is called training, or the Y shape. If the tree, first you are allowing a tree to grow first, and Y shape, two secondaries or four secondaries you are allowing. That is the training operation, and that will be done once initially. Then every year regularly, what you are doing is pruning operation. That will be done in secondary branches or tertiary branches. So that will be you are removing the unproductive branches, overcrowded branches, diseased branches, dead branches. All these unwanted things you will be removing to avoid crowding. It encourages more vegetative growth. Once you are cutting, new flesh will start coming from the cut portion. So that will encourage more growth. And it will control the oversize of the tree also. By removing the by unwanted branches, it will be regulated the canopy. The top of the canopy will be managed by the pruning technique. The shape or structure of the canopy is managed by training operation. So finally, it will regulate the fruiting, and regular cropping will be there. Because So what are the advantages of this pruning? What are the things that we are going to obtain with this pruning means? First one, control the size of the plant. Size, complete the canopy, shape and size we can maintain. We can maintain in an umbrella shape or columnar shape, as I said before. By regular pruning, we can do that. Second one is to regulate exposure to sunlight. Sunlight from which portion you need to get, which are all the leaves you need to get sunlight. Option we can maintain by proper canopy management or proper pruning technique. Increase the size of the fruit by restoring a shoot root ratio. So there is a number called particular number of leaves are required to produce one single fruit. So that balance should be maintained. So the balance we can maintain using this pruning technique. More leaves means more energy will be diverted for leaf production. So that we can reduce number of leaves, and all the energy, all the nutrients and water, minerals, everything we can divert for the production of fruits, so that balance we can maintain. So that is one another importance of pruning. And it facilitates good orchard operations. As I mentioned, proper cleaning, proper spraying operation, proper harvest, everything we can facilitate in a orchard management with a good proper canopy management. Then increase the age of the tree. The tree will be rejuvenated every year. Every year new fresh is coming. The tree will be fresh. So we can increase the age of the tree. That is another importance or the advantage of pruning. It is okay. Old trees can be rejuvenated, and senile orchards can be rejuvenated by this technique. And that again we will be discussing in detail regarding that one. Control pests and diseases. Immediately your pruning means this shoot borer attack is there, or fruit borer attack is there. Like you have to prune immediately and destroy that portion so that it won't spread to another portion. So the canopy will be saved. We can control the disease and control the pest problem by pruning. And regulate the growth and fruiting by regular bearing. In mango, you must be knowing that in old season shoot only fruit reproduce, because that means this year, if a new shoot is producing, we can expect the flowering and fruiting in the next year in the same shoot. and the current season growth, there won't be any flower. It will be in the 1 year behind. So old shoot only, this flowering will be there. So that is the way how we can regulate pruning. Pruning means you need to completely prune a tree. Like we need to maintain some of the older shoots in the tree and cut other portions so that the next year you will get flower and fruiting in the unpruned branches. So like that we can regulate the flowering in a single tree. Okay, then what is the time and what is the age of the tree? So when to go for this pruning and what is the timing? So usually this canopy management practices are followed when the tree is in a dormant stage or when there is a minimum disturbance to the tree physiology. In temperate trees in North Indian conditional world, mostly we will be doing the canopy management operation or pruning operation in winter season so that the tree buds will be in a dormant stage. If you're pruning, again, tree will take some time to revive and next spring season you will get the flower buds. So that is in the case of temperate trees. But the tropical conditional, tropical trees like a mango, we can go for cutting soon after the harvest. But in our condition, we are facing a problem that it will be coinciding with the rainy season. So in our season will start from April, then it will go up to sometimes June, July, August, up to August sometimes. So we can go for pruning immediately after this rainy season. So August to October, that is the time. I feel that this is the right time for go for canopy management in mango in our West Coast situation or Goan condition. And what is the age of the tree? If you ask me the age of the tree, up to 5 to 6 years, you need not to go for any pruning or operation, but initially you need to go for training. Pruning you can start after 4 or 5 years or 5-6 years that time. It depends upon the growth of your tree also. There is no hard and fast rule in canopy management. You can individually observe the tree, each situation of the tree, what is the status of the tree canopy. Then you can decide yourself. So that is the beauty of canopy management. There is no hard and fast rule. It vary from tree to tree. It vary from orchard to orchard. It vary from location to location. So use your like common sense or thumb rules for going for canopy management practice. The mature and non-flowering trees. So as I said, many are complaining or many are blaming regarding the unproductiveness of the trees. In such trees, if there is sufficient growth, if there is a proper canopy, if the tree is bearable, then we can balance the vegetative growth by giving a pruning so that the next season the flower will flower bud will initiate and flowering will we can ensure the flowering. So in such trees we can go for canopy management pruning. So pruning, there are different techniques. First one is heading back. In this picture you can see the tertiary branches are cut like head cuts, completely cutting down. So these are the head cuts. Top portions we can cut down. So these branches from here, 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 you can cut down. So from the down bud cut portion, you can expect a new flesh coming from that portion. Thinning cuts means completely a branch. From the base of the branch you are cutting. That is thinning cuts. Head cuts means top portion only you are cutting. But this means completely you are removing a branch. So there won't be any new development. New branch won't be there. In this thinning out cuts, you are completely removing. Heading back cuts means you are cutting from here and you will be getting a new branch again coming from here. So this heading cuts mostly we are giving to crops like guava, where we every time we need new flesh, every time we need new branches. So that each new branch you will be getting more fruits. So heading cuts usually for current bearing trees. Thin cuts are usually followed in mango because we are cutting to remove completely the branches. We don't want this branch because that branch is blocking, because the branch is blocking the sunlight interpolation. So thinning out cuts will need to be followed in mango. Rejuvenation. Rejuvenation is, as the name mentioned, it is the rejuvenation or revival of the existing old orchards. Now, old trees, they are cut back to the manageable size. And we after rejuvenation, we can go for the top working with new varieties or improved varieties to rejuvenate the orchards. That is the technique. Sometimes there will be severe pruning, up to 1 meter height. We are completely pruning the trees, and from there new flesh started coming, or top working we will do. That is one technique. Different models of rejuvenation will be discussing later. Rejuvenation improves the production, but one thing is here. Rejuvenation means you will be losing the crop for at least 2 to 3 years. You won't get anything. So rejuvenation, if you are practicing, better to go for alternate rows. One row you can keep for this year, another row you can go for pruning or rejuvenation in this season. So that means completely you are going to cut. That is a rejuvenation practice. It will improve the fruit size. It will increase the quality. And the total overall production of the orchard will be improved by this rejuvenation practice. Another thing is proper aftercare. Aftercare is very important, because severely we are going to cut the trees. Even in pruning and training also, proper aftercare is required. And Dr. Ajay will be discussing in detail regarding the aftercare in mango after pruning. Now we are going to discuss regarding different models of rejuvenation. In the first model, if you see, the main trunk is cut back to 3 to 4 meters from the ground. So you can expect that a big mango tree with a huge trunk, that will be cut to 3 to 4 meters. One side of the tree, one half of the tree is cut back. All the branches are cut back. Another one portion will be remaining. You can imagine that. So the portion that is having leaves will protect the other portion, cut portion, from sunburn and other pest disease problems. So that is one method. Immediately you should give the aftercare treatments and all with water, white water based paint, or cow dung slurry also you can apply. Immediately after the next season, no new flesh will be coming in this cut portion. So from that also you need to remove the unwanted shoots. Don't allow all the shoot that is coming from the cut portion. To remove the unwanted shoot and select the most vigorous new shoots that is spaced evenly in 4 directions. What is the shape you want? That branches only you should allow in the trunk, and all other branches should be removed. And in different height, you can expect these branches. You can arrange from the initial time itself, you can pinch down or you can cut those unwanted branches, so that only the vigorous wood, properly spaced branches only will grow, and the tree will get a very good shape after rejuvenation. After this process, every time you need to repeat. Whenever new flesh started coming, you need to select the appropriate ones and pinch out the other things. That is the very important operation. Otherwise, again, crowding will happen. So, when the allowed branches will take over, it will become dominant. Till that time, you need to go for the pinching. Once it started become thick, and once it started already established that branches, then no need to go for pinching, because that branch will grow continuously and the tree will get a good structure, skeleton structure. Okay, now the second model. Second model is severe skeletoning, cutting back the branches of the tree till one basic premise. In large trees, such kind of cut is given, like severe cutting. As I said, 1 meter height, completely tree is cut down. There won't be any branches, nothing will be there. So, what happened means you will get a structure, proper structure you can see. Only the trunk and major branches, primary branches will be there. So, there won't be any other leaves. In this case, more attention you need to give, more water, more nutrients, proper aftercare you need to give, because there won't be any leaves remaining in this severe skeletoning or severe rejuvenation process. Another thing is moderate skeletoning. In this, large branches only will be cutting. The main trunk will be remaining, primary branches will be remaining, and the secondary branches, the major one will allow, and all the small branches coming from the secondary branch will be cutting them. So there will be leaves that will protect the plants, unlike severe pruning, severe rejuvenation. Okay. The whole trunk and remaining branches should be painted with diluted. Okay. That painting and aftercare operation should be given to the cut branches in this moderate skeletoning or moderate oxygenation processes. So this is the second model. In our country, there are two major institutes working in mango. They have done a lot of work in mango pruning and other aspects also. One is the Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. They have conducted some, they had conducted some training, pruning experiments and found that third order pruning, that means pruning in the tertiary branches to 30 centimeter from the point of origin. From the starting up to 30 centimeter, you need to cut the tertiary branch. Such kind of pruning given to Alfonso has given maximum yield. So that is the experimental research that they are projecting. And similarly, experiment was conducted in Central Institute of Subtropical Horticulture Research, Lucknow also. They have found that second order branches, in secondary branches, cutting, pruning in the second order branches gave good result, up to 57.99 kg per tree in Desheri variety they have pruned. So this is these are the another two major examples of canopy management practices given, done by two major institutes. Central Institute of Subtropical Horticulture has rejuvenated also many trees of 40-50 years old mango orchards in Uttar Pradesh, and they found that the main branches were cut up to 5 meters from the ground level during December. I said, like temperate north Indian condition, they will go for pruning in the winter season. So during winter, they have pruned mango trees up to 5 meters and allowed 3 to 4 branches in the 5 meter high trunk. And they may try to maintain the canopy in an umbrella shape for the rest of the years. These trees which are pruned by these methods gave very good result. High productivity was there in such trees. So this is the result given by Central Subtropical Horticultural Research Institution. Another thing is top working. After this rejuvenation, when we are cutting the trees, next thing is the rejuvenation. In the rejuvenation, the upper grade seedlings of planting, means maybe it's a seedling population, it's an old senile seedling plantation. So we will be rejuvenating or cutting it, and we will be top working or grafting the Alfonso or Kesar or Mantra, any new or improved variety, we will be top working on the tree. When the new flesh started coming, we will be grafting in situ. So that is the top working activity. And softwood grafting during monsoon season that can be adopted here. So when the orchard will be completely, we can replant with the other variety. No need to go for replanting, rejuvenate with the new variety. So that operation is called top working. After rejuvenation, when new flesh started coming, you can graft the existing mango trees with new cultivars. So that operation is called top. Advantages of top working is it will increase the productivity of the orchard. No need to go for again land preparation, planting. All these things not required because already the tree is existing. So establishment will be very fast. Fastly you can get the production productivity in a rejuvenated orchard. Then conversion of old and senile orchards into productive orchard, that is possible. Inferior seedling population can be converted into a desirable good variety population using top working. That is another advantage. Grafting of several varieties in the same plant, that is also possible. It's like a fancy operation. Sometimes we sell that in single variety, single tree, we can go for 2 to 3 varieties. So that is also possible in case of top working. Increase the fruit set and fruit production in the orchard, that is possible here. And pollinizer varieties also can be included. There is no extra space taking. The rejuvenation means the same orchard where you can include many varieties. So that is, that option is possible. Additional income from the sales of the pruned woods. It's a huge tree. It's a big orchard, means you're pruning all the trees, means that trunk portion, that timber portion also you can be used for extracting extra income. Disadvantages, as I mentioned earlier, if you're not giving the proper aftercare after the severe pruning, there will be a chance of death of the tree. So that you should be very careful regarding that. And best management practices after pruning you should give. And there will be crop loss of 2 to 3 years. That is inevitable. We can't manage that. At least 2 to 3 years you should bear the loss. Or otherwise you need to reduce. Half of the orchard should be originated in one period and another half in another period. That way you need to plan accordingly. There is a chance of pest and disease occurrence because already the tree is cut. So there is an exposed region. Proper management, if it is not there, stem borer and that attack will be there. So you should be very careful at that. And it needed proper labor, a skilled labor for the thinning of the shoots, removal of the side shoot and all, because the proper judgment of the tree, proper canopy structure, we should be aware which are the branches that are required, which are the branches that are going to bear, which are useful. Such kind of judgment is required. So a skillful labor, or the owner himself or herself, if she can do that, that will be a good thing. A skilled labor, that is very much essential. Now, some tips for a better or successful pruning. First thing is your tool. What are the type of tools that you're using? Always use a sharp tools so that the tree won't be damaged. Tree should have a proper cut. And always better to cut from the down portion first to 20 to 40 millimeter to the underside first, then give a top cut so that there won't be any breakage of the branches. If you're cutting from the top, there is a chance that the tree branch will break with the wind. So always give a slanting cut from the underside first, then go for the top cut. So that is another technique. The cut should be always slanting so that the water or dew, nothing will stand on the portion. And if the water is standing, there is a chance for infestation, fungal disease development and all. So better to give a slanting cut. And the final thing is proper aftercare management. So now coming to the tools and equipments for canopy management, I'll be just showing the pictures only. These are equipment which are very, very familiar to all of you. Sicatures, sicature usage. I have seen many people using sicatures in wrong way. This is the right way to use a sicature. So, and the way how you are cutting the branches, it should start from the node. This is the portion. From close to the trunk or branch you need to cut, not from this portion. If you're cutting, you will get a new branch from here. Thinning of cut should be given exactly at the point of origin. So sicatures, next one is this saw. You can use for slightly bigger branches. You can use this one. And tree pruners up to 2 to 2.5 inch, you can go for shears or this tree pruners. Chainsaws mainly for cutting the tree trunks, bigger one. Trunks you can use this motorized or mechanical power operated chainsaws. Nowadays people are going for a hydraulic trolley, or this is a trolley, self-propelled machine. It can be you moved inside the orchard, then according to the height we can go to the proper height of the tree and cut that, and a person can stand there and cut or sit there and cut the branches. It is attached to the chains also, so up to 20, 25 to 30 feet height trees can be regulated or pruned by using this hydraulic trolley platform. So at the end of the presentation, I tried to tell the what are the major factors of canopy management, what is the canopy architecture, how important is canopy management mango, and how it is required for the better quality production, high yield and good sustainable orchard, and what are the operations, like training operation the initial years and pruning operations every year, annual. And finally, how to rejuvenate your old and existing orchards using top working. So this is it. Thank you very much. If you have any question or doubt regarding this one, please feel free to ask.